Jon Gruden is no longer the Raiders coach after emails revealed that he made homophobic, racist, and sexist remarks. Now, in a statement, Gruden said the following: "I love the Raiders and do not want to be a distraction. Thank you to all the players, coaches, staff, and fans of Raider Nation. I'm sorry, I never meant to hurt anyone." Now, the tone of the emails in question certainly seemed like he meant to hurt people, or at least had some pretty awful views of various people. Now, the resignation letter came almost immediately after the New York Times had reported on email exchanges between Gruden and Bruce Allen while Allen was the president of the Redskins, which of course now is known as the Washington Football Team. They're expected to debut their new name next year. But nonetheless, Gruden's departure from the team comes as other outlets have also reported various details about what he had said in these exchanges, email exchanges between 2011 and 2018. In the Times report, for instance, Gruden also reportedly said that Roger Goodell should not have encouraged Jeff Fisher, who was then coaching the Rams, to draft queers, which was a reference to Michael Sam, a gay player the team added in 2014. Gruden also called for the firing of Eric Reed, who knelt during the playing of the national anthem. By the way, he also referred to Goodell with an anti-gay slur, the F word. You can obviously figure out what that is. Gruden also exchanged emails with Allen and other men that contained photos of women who were only wearing bikini bottoms, according to the Times. One of the photos featured an email reportedly showing two Washington football team cheerleaders topless. So this was all going on. I've got more details about the emails and more, but he has decided to step down. My guess is he was probably gonna be forced to resign. So he stepped down claiming that he didn't wanna be a distraction.
Yeah, so in the beginning there was just one email JR and I talked about on the show last night, and it was about the player association lead's lips, and it was a racist stereotype and trope. And at the time I said that they should have a conversation on TV about it, including Gruden, because this is what I say almost every time. Rather than just firing him and having everybody get mad, let's talk it through and see why that's a racist trope, especially if he didn't know it. And I said, well, I don't know who Gruden is. I have no idea if he's a guy who normally thinks this or was an aberration and he really meant that the guy was lying, as it was his defense. And if he didn't mean it, then that conversation they have on air would help to educate him and educate other people who don't know about it. And I've suggested that 100 times with Megyn Kelly, etc. Right? Now you see all the emails. No, that he definitely meant it. Context is everything. So he wasn't joking. It wasn't among friends who were gay or black, etc. It wasn't like inside the family. No, it was a bunch of white right wingers who were in positions of power at the time. Gruden was on ESPN, but he's joking with the, I think it was the general manager of the Washington football team, okay, who's another deeply Republican right winger. Mm-hmm. And they're all talking about how gay people are terrible. They shouldn't be allowed in the NFL. Women are terrible. They shouldn't be allowed to be referees. Look, if people like to focus on the things that they think are easiest to defend. Oh, they're passing around naked pictures. That's not our business. Okay, if it was just rando naked pictures, okay, I guess. And that's where context matters. And by the way, people on the left might be mad at me for saying that, right? But it wasn't random people. It was people who worked for Bruce Allen. They worked for the Washington football team. They were cheerleaders there.
Right.
This guy's passing around people's, his employees' pictures. And Gruden's like, oh yeah, way to go. Way to look at your employees naked, right? And right now the only openly gay player is on the Raiders. And Gruden in the email says you shouldn't draft queers. It's no way. And then Eric Reed, all these people that are don't know anything about football say, oh yeah, Colin Kaepernick, he wasn't banned from the league because he was protesting police abuse. He wouldn't have made the league anyway. You guys don't know a damn thing about football. We had quarterbacks throwing 5 interceptions and a half. Colin Kaepernick ran for 181 yards in a legendary game in the playoffs, brought him to the Super Bowl. Anyway, I'm not having that conversation. But Eric Reed is also an indisputably great player. And in the emails, Gruden says he should be fired for kneeling. So he's so deeply racist that he says even great players, if they dare protest the police killing unarmed black men, they should be immediately fired from the league. Nah, he's a terrible guy, terrible guy. And of course, what's conservative reaction? Almost every conservative online, Don Jr., everyone on Newsmax, OAN, they're like, poor Jon Gruden. He was just being racist and sexist and homophobic like the rest of us. Oh my God, I can't believe they canceled him. How are black players supposed to work with him? How is the gay player supposed to work with him when they know he hates them? That's insane. It's insane. You guys don't get it. So, of course, I'll summarize with Charlie Kirk. He says the real reason they had to get rid of Jon Gruden is because he's a white Catholic conservative male who speaks out.
Except he didn't speak out.
That's exactly right, yeah. Anna. He didn't speak out. He just talked to his other right wing friends. Mm-hmm. And he's like, now guys, remember, and remember the guy he's talking to is in charge of the Washington team. He makes decisions on who they hire. Do they want female referees in their games or don't they? Are they gonna draft a gay player or are they gonna ban every gay player? Because that's apparently what Gruden wants. Are they gonna fire any black player who dares to protest police abuse? That's what Gruden wanted. He wasn't public about that. And when he was caught with just that one email, he came out and said, oh, I don't have racial bone in my body. Nah, he's a giant liar. Screw Gruden. And by the way, if you're defending Gruden based on all those comments, guess what? That means you're a racist and sexist. And you assume that everybody thinks like you. And you say, what's the big deal? Almost every conservative says, what's the big deal? Everybody said that. No, not everybody has said you should throw out every black player who does not favor police abuse and throw out every gay player from the NFL. You guys are monsters. And by the way, yes, it matters the context. So was it joking, not joking, etc. If it was joking, it doesn't make it good, but you could have a conversation around it. If he didn't mean it, you could have a conversation around it, right? But if he meant it, which he most clearly did now that we see the emails, and you think he doesn't have to go, that he should be in charge. Well, he's a white male Catholic. He should be in charge of those people and they should know their roles. I got news for you, that means you're a racist. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.